How much sleep do we need, and does that change throughout our lives?
Well, again, I think that it's increasingly recognized that you really do need about 8 hours of sleep. So your mother was right. You know, you do need that much sleep. And depending on if you want to be tip-top performance, you may need closer to 9 hours of sleep. And so you'll meet people who say, I only need 6 hours of sleep. And maybe those people exist, but if they do, they're really rare, like one in a million. And otherwise, they're getting by using what you and I get by with, which is coffee or other, you know, stimulants.
This is water, by the way.
Yeah, right, yeah. But no, you probably do need 8 hours of sleep. And we were talking a little bit about sleep and learning, but sleep is important for things like your immune system. And so if you ask people how much they sleep, and people that only get 6 hours of sleep, they're more likely to get pneumonia, you know, going forward than people who get 8 hours of sleep. And if you look at people and ask them how much sleep do you get and then look to see how many heart attacks they have down the road, people who sleep only 6 hours a night get more heart attacks than people who sleep 8 hours per night.
My teen sons keep Googling information that tells me that teenagers need to sleep more and get up later and school should start later.
That's correct.
And so this changes throughout your life.
Yeah, it's not totally worked out how much sleep you need, although there are changes in the kinds of sleep. There are different kinds of stages of sleep at night. But in particular, around the teenage years, you know, late teenage years, early 20s, the time that you want to go to sleep and the time that you want to get up do shift later. And so
do schools need to respond to that?
It's very possible. You know, the best researcher on this is, if you Google Owens and sleep, my name doesn't come up, but Judith Owens, who's in Washington, D.C., is a big proponent of this, and she's done a lot of work on this, and there are many kids who are sleeping through the first couple periods of the day. And what would make the most sense is basically getting middle schoolers to school on time at 7 o'clock, and then having the high schoolers come back at, you know, maybe 9 o'clock.
Wow.
And people would have more effective first periods of class. They learn more, they would, you know, do better on tests.